Do you work on apps with really complex workflows? Things like enterprise apps, software for finance, CAD modeling, or complicated creative production, right? Where the tasks users need to complete, they're repetitive, but they're also really thoughtful and analytical. You probably can't just make everything simpler by limiting the functionality. People have to get their work done. So how do you keep complex apps usable? There are two key principles that can really help. The first principle is keep context visible. Resist the temptation to use modals and wizards on complex apps. Why? They hide that contextual information that assists users' working memories. Designers often try and keep things simple and streamlined by using wizards, modal pop-ups, and separate pages for adding or editing information. It might seem like these patterns would help keep users focused on the task at hand and keep the interface simple, but this prevents them from seeing the work that they've already done, and that is really critical context. While modals and wizards are occasionally appropriate, more often than not, context is king. Users often try and solve new tasks using the knowledge that they already have. So plan for that. If you have to set up a complicated process, like setting up an automated backup job for your company's servers, for example, but you only do it once a quarter, you might not remember exactly how you did it in the past, and you would want to refer to what you did last time. It reminds you of what an acceptable solution to that problem looks like, rather than starting from scratch. So instead of modals or a wizard that would prevent users from referencing existing data, try using design patterns that let them edit or add information in the context of their existing data. That way, you don't have to go back and forth between screens to refer to key information, keeping it in your working memory as you go. The app itself acts like a form of external memory for the user, which is tremendously helpful. They have enough cognitive and working memory load as they work through these complicated multi-stage workflows. The second major principle, support safe exploration. When people are tackling big, complex problems that don't have clear solutions, we frequently see them creating a second copy of their work and trying a totally different approach. Basically, they create what-if scenarios. This happens in all kinds of contexts, from creative work all the way to big enterprise apps. So support this. Design things so that opening another copy and trying a different solution doesn't have an interaction cost. Give people tools that help them compare their different solutions in an apples-to-apples way. Like this stock trading app that lets users create multiple what-if scenarios and compare them on the attributes that matter to them. That means that you have to do user research to understand the types of attributes that your users really care about when they're comparing. And if you really want to be doing some truly innovative UX work, the things that no one has figured out perfectly yet, figure out how to merge multiple versions of your users' work together seamlessly. Let them create a greatest hits version. That's the kind of helpful design pattern that can really improve people's complex workflows, rather than just radically simplifying the user interface.